you.
Hello everyone, today we will learn about the human skeletal system. In this video, we will learn what is skeleton and function of skeleton, structure of bone, parts of skeletal system, skull, backbone, ribcage, limbs and girdles, and all about joints. Okay, so let's start. The skeletal system. Our skeleton is a framework of bone that hold our body together. A newborn baby has more than 300 bones. As the baby grow older, some bones join together. So adult has only 206 bones. Functions of skeletal system. Our skeletal system gives shape to our body. It also protects our internal organs, like skull protect our brain, ribcage protects our heart and lungs, and vertebral column protect our spinal cord. Bones along with muscles help us to move our body parts. Most of the blood cells are produced in our bones. Okay. Structure of bone. The bone are made up of tissues. The outer covering of bone is hard, so it is called compact bone. From the inside, the bones are spongy and soft, so they are called spongy bones. Bones also contain soft tissue called bone marrow. It produces red blood cells. So it is also called body's factory for producing red blood cells. Bones are composed of calcium, phosphorus, and fibrous substance called collagen. Parts of the skeleton. Our skeleton consists of skull, backbone, which starts from neck to the lower back, ribcage, limbs, forelimbs and hind limbs, and girdles, pelvic girdle and pectoral girdle. Now let's study them in detail. Skull. The skull provides a protective case for the brain and support the structure of the face. Our skull consists of two parts, cranium, and lower part is facial bone. Facial bone. Our skull is made up of 22 bones. Out of these 22 bones, 8 bones form cranium and 14 bones form our face, so called facial bones. These support our eyes, nose and our mouth. The bones of the skull are rigid. Rigid means fixed. Okay, but the lower jaw bone is movable. Movable. So from out of all the 22 bones, only the lower jaw bone is movable. Functions of the skull. It protects the brain and it protects the sense organ of the face. Backbone. The long flexible bone extending from our neck to the end of the back. End of the back is called backbone. It is also called vertebral column and spine. The backbone is made up of 33 small bones called vertebrae. So first 7 vertebrae are called cervical vertebrae from C1 to C7. These present in our neck region. The next 12 vertebrae from T1 to T12 vertebrae are called thoracic vertebrae, and these present in our chest. Okay. Then next 5 lumbar vertebrae present in our belly. 5 sacrum. 5 sacrum vertebrae form hip region. Our hip region. Present in our hip region. And 4 coccyx form tailbone. tail, bone. Functions of spine. Our spine protect the spinal cord and it form the main axis of the skeleton, hence help to support the body. Rib cage. It is a cage-like structure formed by 12 pair of bow-shaped bone. This 12 pair of bow-shaped bone is called ribs. The rib cage has another long bone in front, this one. Okay, this is called sternum or breastbone. The ribs are attached in front to the sternum. They are attached in front to the sternum, and at the back they are attached to the backbone. Okay. The last two pair of ribs, means this 11 and 12, are only attached to the backbone and they are not attached to the sternum, so they are called floating ribs. The first seven pair, this one, the first seven pair is directly attached to the, look at this, they are directly attached to the sternum, so they are called true ribs. And 8th, 9th and 10th pair is not directly attached with the sternum, okay, so they are called false rib. Function of the rib cage. It protects the delicate internal organs such as heart and lungs, and it also take part in our breathing movement. Limbs. There are two pair of limbs in our body, forelimbs and hind limbs. Forelimbs means our arm and hind limbs means our leg. Our arm and leg are made up of many bones. The bone of our upper arm is called humerus and our lower arm is made up of two bones, radius and ulna. There are 27 bones present in our hand and wrist. 27 bones present in our hand and wrist. The bone of our upper leg is called femur. This is also called thigh bone. This is also called thigh bone, and this is the longest bone in our body. So which is the longest bone in our body? Femur. Femur is the longest bone in our body. The lower leg contain two bones, tibia and fibula. The ankle and foot contain 26 bones. Total 26 bones contain this part of the leg, means ankle and foot. And do you know that the hand and the feet of our body contain about more than half of the total number of bones in our body? Girdles. There are two girdles present in a human skeleton, pectoral or shoulder girdles, because this is present in shoulder regions, so also called shoulder girdles, and pelvic or hip girdles, because this is present in hip region. Okay, the pectoral girdle connect our upper limb to the body. Upper limbs means our arms, our arms to the body. This is humerus and this connect it to the whole body. And it is made up of clavicle or collarbone and scapula or shoulder blade. Okay. The hip girdle connect the lower limbs. Lower limbs means our legs. This is connect to the femur. Okay. Lower limbs to the body, and it support and protect the lower organ of the body. Joints. The place where two bones meet is called a joint. This is one bone, this is second bone, and this place is called joint, where two bones meet. Joint enable our rigid skeleton to move. The end of our bone, this blue one, the end of our bones are covered with a thin layer of cartilage. This is cartilage. It is an elastic tissue that prevent the bones from rubbing against each other at the joint. Now the ligaments, this pink one, the ligaments means all the bones in our body are held together by a strong connective tissue. This is a strong connective tissue which is known as ligament. There are two type of joint in our body, immovable joint and movable joint. Immovable joint means they do not allow any movement of the bones. The joint in the skull, where this immovable joint present, the joint in the skull are immovable joint. Now, movable joint means they allow movement in different direction. Types of movable joint. Our body has four types of movable joint. So first is ball and socket joint. In this type of joint, one bone has a ball shaped end, whereas the other bone has cup shaped socket. You can see that this is cup like and this is ball like. So the ball shaped end of bone, one bone fit into the cup shaped socket of the other bone. So this allow maximum movement. This type of joint present in our hip and our shoulder. You can see this. This is a hip joint. So the end of the femur is like ball shaped and this is hip bone. This is work as a cup shaped bone. So this fit in this and this allow maximum movement. Similarly, our shoulder has same type of joint. Okay. Now second type of joint is hinge joint. Okay. Like our door hinges allow the door. This is door and this is the door hinges. It allow it to open in only one way. Similarly, hinge joint allow the bones to move only in one direction. So this is the hinge joint present in our body. Okay, and this type of joint found in elbow, fingers, knees and toes. Okay, third type of joint is pivot joint. So what is the meaning of this pivot? Pivot means this is a point. This is a point of an object, of an object where other object is moved. Okay, where other object is moved. Look at this picture. This is a seesaw. Okay, so this is the fixed point of seesaw and this both side move on this fixed point. Okay, similarly in the pivot joint, this is the fixed point of our pivot joint and this move along this. Okay, so this type of joint present in our between the skull and the first two vertebrae of the backbone. Okay, and this type of joint allow to move our head up, down and sideways. Okay, fourth type of joint is gliding joint. So this type of joint allow the bone to slip over one another. This type of joint found in our wrist, ankle and vertebrae of the spine. So this type of joint help the back to bend and twist. Okay. Terms to remember. Bone marrow, soft spongy tissue inside the bone where new blood cells are formed. Vertebrae, bones that form the backbone. Sternum, the long bone in the front of rib cage. Floating ribs, the last two pair of ribs that are attached only to the backbone and not to the sternum. Femur, the longest bone of the body which is located in the thigh region. Joints, place where two bones meet. Ligament, tissue that hold the bone together. Cartilage, an elastic tissue that prevents the bone from rubbing against each other at the joint. Hope you enjoyed the video. Now let's test your concept with this quiz and send me answer in the comment box below.